These workers are doing a service to the public, but in the process, they're also doing a disservice to themselves. They're potentially injuring themselves, making themselves unhealthy, and also contaminating the environment around them. The work I've been doing the past several years has focused on understanding the impacts of electronic waste recycling, or e-waste. This is a project that started in Ghana and then moved to Thailand, and most recently we've been doing this work in Chile, trying to understand why do people pursue this line of work, what are the impacts of this work on their health and on the environment. E-waste is very much a global problem. It turns out there's more than 40 million tons of e-waste getting produced every year, and that number goes up every year. We've been working exclusively with informal e-waste workers. So these are people that are working for themselves. The process is remarkably similar no matter where you go. The goal being to take out one of two things, either reusable parts. So if there's a hard drive in there you can use, people can sell that. That's immediate income. If there's not, then they break it down and they try to get to the metals inside. So things like copper and gold and silver and other precious metals that they can resell and make a living on. Unfortunately, it turns out e-waste also contains a lot of toxic chemicals, things like lead and cadmium and mercury. So in getting those valuables, people inadvertently release these toxic chemicals into themselves and the environment. And that's what we're trying to understand and reduce. The participants in our study have been outstanding partners. Initially, as you might imagine, there was a little hesitation. For us to assess the impacts on your health, we're going to measure the environment around you, we're going to measure the air you breathe, we're going to measure the noise that you're exposed to, but then we're going to take some measurements inside your body too and see how those exposures are influencing your health. So our research is ongoing, but some of our preliminary results suggest that many of these people do have elevated levels of heavy metals in their blood over what we would consider to be a safe level. We're also finding that the vast majority of these people are getting injured a lot doing this work. There's glass flying everywhere. This is glass that contains lead as well. And again, our key thing is we want to work with the community after we figure out the impacts to figure out what's next. And my job as a public health specialist is to make sure that they are doing this as healthy and safe as they can with minimal impact on themselves and the environment.